When we saw what's possible with ChatGPT, it was pretty obvious to me that the world was about to change. One of the first places we launched was an online high school that we do with Arizona State University called the Khan World School. And it has students from all over the world, including one young woman from India. Her name is Sanvi, or she says, well, you know, I was reading The Great Gatsby, and I kept wondering why he looks at the green light in the distance. And then Sanvi realized that I could actually talk to Jay Gatsby using Khanmigo. And so the AI simulated Jay Gatsby. She asked Jay Gatsby, and he said, oh, sport, it symbolizes this and that. And not only did Sanvi get her answer, but then she ended up having a very in-depth conversation with Jay Gatsby. It just shows you how immersive and how rich experiences like this are. It unlocks a depth to any dimension of learning that would have seemed science fiction a year ago.
The world has a food problem. We need to grow 50% more food compared to today's levels to feed the growing population of the world. So then the question is, how do we get to increased good food production without harming the planet? One of the most promising approaches to get there is that of data-driven agriculture. We have been working on AI for agriculture for about 9 years. Generative AI has been the significant leap in helping us getting AI to every farmer anywhere in the world. With ChatGPT, a farmer can converse with the insights, irrespective of where they are, what language they speak.
I lost my sight when I was 7. And ever since then, I've been interested in technology and how it can have an impact to improve people's lives. A few years ago, I got the opportunity to follow my passion and to work on Seeing AI, which is a talking camera app for people who are blind. About a year ago, we started hearing about generative AI and experimenting with the different ways it can help. But the recent announcement a couple of months ago of GPT-4, now that just took things to a whole new level.
Smaller white text. Below the text, there is an illustration of a pink fish. The sign is hanging above the entrance of a restaurant.
The big difference is now these large models have been trained to recognize so many different things. And the language capabilities, we can get very rich, vivid descriptions of images and the world around us.
The crane is extended upwards and appears to be in use.
Sometimes when I'm out and about with my son, I really enjoy having those conversations about the things around us.
Tell me about the starfish.
The most distinctive is the bright orange starfish, which stands out against the darker colors of the other starfish.
My son and I have so many fun adventures, and it's incredible to think what this will enable us to share together. I imagine this future where AI and humans work together, where the AI understands us each as individuals and can fill in the gaps for each and every one of us.